Hi, my name is Donner from the Microsoft Store in Farmington, Connecticut, and today I'm going to share with you some tips to help you do your math, reading, and writing work right at home. Do you find it tedious to browse the web for reputable sources or viable information for your paper? Well, Microsoft Word Researcher does this in just a few simple steps. We'll go to References, Researcher, and then we'll type in the box below here. And we're going to search Renaissance Architecture. Once you hit enter, you'll see your topics to the right. You'll have relevant topics up top and more sources below. So I like this article here, and we'll scroll down in our document. And we want to take this first sentence. So we'll highlight it, and then we'll hit Control C to copy. And we'll click at the end of this paragraph. And we'll go to the center option, Merge Formatting, just to keep things consistent. And then we can see that it added it to the bottom of that paragraph. And then we'll hit add this source as a citation. And then we can hit create a bibliography as well. And now we have a bibliography to go along with our citation. Perfect. And it was all done through Microsoft Word Researcher.
We all learn differently. Within Immersive Reader, all learners can improve upon their writing and reading skills.
I already have a pre-made section made for Immersive Reader, and it reads, "Today I went to the supermarket. I bought 2 apples, a gallon of milk, a loaf of bread, and ice cream." To open this up in Immersive Reader, we'll go to the View tab, click on Immersive Reader, and then our text will open up. We do have options that we can navigate to on this right side that can change the way we view our text. We can change our font, we already have increased spacing, and we can add a theme. I'm going to choose green. Then if we go to Grammar options, we can show syllables, we can show nouns, verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. We can also go to our reading preferences. Right now we have on picture dictionary, so if we go over Apple, it'll show us a picture. One cool feature I like is line focus. Line focus allows you to focus on each individual line as you read through. The last feature inside of here is translate, so you can translate this to any language. Right now we have it by word, which we saw when we clicked on the image. And then we can translate by document. So if we translate by document, since we're set to Spanish, it'll translate the whole document into Spanish. We also have read aloud. These are our settings for read aloud. You can either be a female or a male. We can also change the speed. I'm gonna change it to 1.25, and then we're gonna hit play right here.
"Today I went to the supermarket. I bought 2 apples, a gallon of milk, a loaf of bread, and ice cream."
These are all features that you can use within Immersive Reader and help you find it beneficial as you use OneNote.
Are you the type of learner that benefits from examples, especially in math? OneNote Math Assistant is a perfect tool for you.
Math Assistant also lives within OneNote. Let's do 7x squared plus 8x minus 2 equals 63. Let's go ahead and circle it. Now we can use our math button on the top. Then it'll show our equation in the math section to the right. Then we can go ahead and click on select an action, and we can solve for x. As you can see, both our answers pop up there. And then we can go ahead and show the steps. We're going to choose quadratic formula. Now we can navigate through each step. And this one is going to give us a total of 16 whole steps that we can follow to help navigate through this complex equation. So this is an example of how you can use Math Assistant within OneNote to help you solve complex equations and show the steps in order to get to the answer.
Thank you for checking out our videos on how to make schoolwork easier from home.